Across Australia, First Nations people are up to 10 times more likely to go blind, often from preventable causes. In Queensland, though, that's changing thanks to a mobile eye clinic that's bringing first-class treatment to some of the most remote corners of the state. Queensland correspondent Ella Archibald-Binge reports.
You look at the place, look, this is paradise.
You look at this view, you look at these islands, you look at Kerrisshore, you look at Phantom, you look at Orpheus, you look at the Pacific, you look at the coast. Our people can't see that beauty.
Palm Island is one of Australia's most visually stunning locations. It lies just 70 kilometres off the coast of Townsville in North Queensland. A small stretch of water that represents an oceanic divide in health outcomes for the island's 3,000 residents. Uncle Joe Rubin is just one of at least 200 Palm Islanders living with type 2 diabetes. He recently noticed some irritation in his eyes and went straight to the doctor.
A bit itchy and under water, like a bit dripping from your eye. And then you hardly read like a newspaper, you know. You can't like see properly. So I knew straight away with my cataract. When I go check to the doctor and said, they found out I got a cataract.
Originally from the Torres Strait, his favourite pastime is spearfishing during the low tide. But with his vision impaired, that's nearly impossible.
Oh, the life is very hard because if you're cataract and you can see proper, how can you do your cooking and you go for a walk to buy your grocery or go for fishing and all that, you know? So you better get rid of their cataract so you can see properly what you're doing.
Uncle Joe needs ongoing treatment to save his sight, but that's been difficult and expensive to access until now. The Indigenous Diabetes Eyes and Screening Van, or IDEAS Van, provides free health clinics to Queensland's Indigenous communities. Its mission to stamp out avoidable blindness.
Well, ophthalmology equipment is usually only in city-based hospitals. And if this was really going to help the people who needed it most, it would be those people who didn't have access to the city-based hospitals. So how do you get $900,000 worth of equipment to each of those country hospitals? And that's an impossibility. But if you put it all in a giant caravan, you could take it to each of those places where the treatment can happen in their own community.
The van travels to 8 communities every 2 months, including Palm Island, Rockhampton, Bundaberg, Hervey Bay, Cherbourg, Toowoomba, Charleville and Mount Isa.
It allows to have world state-of-the-art equipment and professionals to come here and treat our people.
At today's clinic, patients are in for a surprise. One of the visiting doctors is also Aboriginal.
Where are you from?
So we're Warrigal Birragabi from up here, my great-grandmother's okay. side, and Yagara Yubaba from Brisbane area on my great-grandmother's side, and then Wiradjuri on that side.
Yeah. Gingo!
All over, yeah.
You know more than me about the thing, right here.
Dr. Chris Rallabaker is about to become Australia's first Aboriginal ophthalmologist.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to make it harder now.
Oh, don't.
Based in Brisbane, he helps out on the van whenever he can.
See if that helps.
It was taking me ages to do visual acuities because they want to talk about where I'm from and you know, family and working out the connections.
Why?
It's really nice. Yeah. It gives a depth to the therapeutic relationship that isn't necessarily assumed to be there with a non-Aboriginal Torres Strait Islander doctor. There's a familiarity there. There's an understanding of a common history and of a common background and experience.
for Uncle Joe, today's visit is an important one. The 68-year-old had an operation in Townsville earlier this year to remove his cataracts.
Yeah, come on in.
All right, thank you.
He lives alone on Palm Island.
So I'm going to do a scan on the back of your eye. If you look straight ahead, you'll see a star.
If his eyesight hasn't improved, he'll struggle to drive, cook, do his shopping, or go spearfishing.
Okay, you stare at that. Stare at the star.
He's been trying hard to maintain a healthy lifestyle to combat his diabetes and is about to find out whether his efforts have paid off.
Michael, you could write down some notes, actually.
After a thorough examination, he has his answer.
Great. Look, Jay, your eyes are looking great, you know? You've got had cataract surgery done. That's beautiful. Everything's nice and clear. Your vision's really good. And I'm really pleased to say that you, diabetes-wise, it looks fantastic. I can't tell you're diabetic by looking back at your eyes. Keep up the good work, okay?
After a quick laser treatment to fix some thickening around the capsule of his eye, Uncle Joe is free to leave. Within a few days, his vision will be near perfect. Uncle Joe wastes no time getting back to doing what he loves most.
I'm really happy and really glad to see, like before, you can see clearly, you know, even walking the rip, when the tide come in, the fish come in and looking for food, and you can see them clearly. Even with like cloudy day like today, you can see that fish. We throw the spear.
With 24 sponsors and supporters, and determination from the organisation and the community, Lyndall DeMarco says the van is here to stay.
So I think it's the future. I really do. Not only for ophthalmology, but the most important thing is maybe the people in rural and remote Australia may have access to a level playing field if this sort of model can be extrapolated all around the country.